in this video, I will explain you about the electric current. Friends, let's get started. First of all, understand what is the atomic structure of the atom. As you all know that every substance in the universe is made of atom. An atom itself is made of three tiny particles called neutron, proton and electron. The electron is the negatively charged, the proton is positively charged and the neutron is neutral. Okay. The electron that present in the outermost orbit of the atom, that electron are loosely bounded. When these electrons absorb energy, they start moving in the metal, or we can say when these electrons absorb energy, they start moving freely. Okay, or we can say these electrons detach from the orbit of the atom. Okay, now consider that we have one electrical circuit. The electric circuit means the circuit which provides the continuous path to the flow of current. Okay, this circuit is made of metal. Okay, and as I told you earlier that every substance is made of atoms, so this metal is also made of atoms. Atom consists the loosely bounded electron in their outermost shell. Okay, when we are giving the voltage across these metal, these electrons are energized and they start moving freely in the metal. Okay, but as you all know that electron is negatively charged, so these electrons try to attract the positive terminal of the supply. Because of this attraction, the continuous flow of electron occur in the metal. Okay, and these electron created the current in the circuit. So in short, we can say that the current is nothing but the continuous flow of electron in any closed circuit. The electric current is represented by the symbol I. It is measured in ampere, and ampere is equal to the charge flowing per second. Okay. Now, conventional direction of flow of current. Okay. Friends, as I explained you earlier that the flow of electron induces the current in the circuit. So here in this circuit, the electron flow from high potential to the low potential of the supply. That means the direction of current is in that direction. That means the current flow in that direction. But friends, in actual practice, we are taking the direction of current from positive to the negative terminal of the supply. This is the conventional direction of flow of current. Okay, so this that direction of current is used for designing the circuit.
You need some power source like a cell or a battery, and you need full circuit for electric charge to flow.
Yeah, here it is.
Look at my circuit. It has a battery and two bulbs, and it is complete with wires.
Yeah, it is very good. This kind of circuit is known as simple or series circuit.
Oh, so if this is a simple circuit, is this something called complex circuit?
Ah, there are two kinds of circuit, series and parallel.
So mine is a series circuit. Can you tell me about parallel circuit?
Hold on, my scientist brother. Let's first learn how to draw a circuit on a paper.
Oh, it's so simple. You need to make a picture of a battery and the bulb.
Yes, it is very simple. But in science, there are symbols for everything. Like for bulb, you draw a symbol like this.
Oh, then you need to draw two, as my circuit has two bulbs.
And then the symbol for a cell is like this.
Oh, just two lines?
Now we need to draw lines. To make a circuit, we draw straight lines which take turn at right angles.
Now my circuit is complete. It looks so beautiful.
Like I told you, this is known as series circuit.
Are there any benefits from this kind of circuit?
There are two benefits. One, it uses less amount of wires. And the second advantage is that if you want a warning that one of the components in the circuit has failed, then the series circuit is used.
Now I understand all about this simple circuit. Can you make a parallel circuit?
Oh yes, let's make a parallel circuit for you. Like I told you before, it requires more wires than simple circuit.
Wow, both bulbs are on. Can you remove one wire from the first?
Look, only one bulb has gone off. The second bulb is still on. Okay, now you have understood parallel circuit. Can you draw it on the chart?
Oh, yes. Here it is. Is it okay?
Perfect. Let's clap for your work. Now, can you tell me one benefit of parallel circuit?
Parallel circuits are useful if you want everything to work, even if one component has failed.
This is why our homes are wired with parallel circuit.
So even if one thing goes off, at least other things will continue to work?